Representative Susan Davis arrived in Congress in 2001. Her seat was then redistricted, and from 2003 to 2020, that district, the 53rd, has been as blue as the Pacific Ocean. But with an open seat race and a crowded field of lots of Democrats, can a Republican make it to the runoff? Pamela Ramos is a Republican running for this seat. She joins me now. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
So I'll start with you the same way that I started with a number of other candidates for the 53rd. It feels like a large district, parts of El Cajon, parts of San Diego, parts of Eastern Chula Vista. What do you feel are the biggest issues facing the district right now?
Well, the district encompasses, it's a huge military town, and I think some of the issues there are with our military. We need to make sure that our military and their families are well compensated for. These are the men and women that fight for our country, and I think they deserve a lot better than what they're getting. And a related issue would be the Veterans Affairs. They're not receiving the benefits and healthcare that they were promised when they signed up. I think if a you had something to say?
No, I was going to say, how would you want to help those veterans and this military community if you were elected to Congress?
Well, first off, the government should be more accountable and more transparent with the funding that these families and the veterans receive.
Let me ask you this. How would you work? You've worked in the healthcare industry for a large part of your career, correct? How would your work and experience in the healthcare industry apply to what you would bring as a congresswoman for this district?
Well, I've worked a lot in biotech, and I'm a nurse, worked in biotech. I currently work with a company called Therapeutic Solutions International, and they're a cancer immunotherapy and nutraceutical company. And what they do is they create and commercialize treatments for life-threatening diseases such as cancer, CTE, and PTSD, which is huge in our homeless and veteran population. I think encouraging and incentivizing these companies can lead to solutions for these problems that we have right now.
We started with obviously military issues, but would healthcare be one of the main things that you would focus on in this race?
Yeah, that's a related issue, I think, especially in that population.
And tell me, you're running as a Republican in this district. Mm-hmm. We'll get to kind of the challenges when it comes to registration in a second about that. But I want to ask, because everyone is looking at the Republican Party and how it relates to President Donald Trump right now. Do you think if you were elected to Congress, you would be more of a rubber stamp, someone who would be a full supporter of the president, or do you see yourself more like a moderate, like a Senator Mitt Romney from Utah?
I would, you have to take each case by case basis. I agree with a lot of his policies, and I think, but I'm my own person. I'm still my own person, and I'm going to follow what my heart tells me.
Do you feel as though this district wants a representative who is a large supporter of President Trump?
Well, this district, well, as a representative, I'm going to listen to what everyone wants and what everyone needs and follow what the district says.
Tell me, the interesting part about this race, and this is what I started with, Susan Davis, Congressman Susan Davis, she's had this seat for a number of years, and she's held it blue. The registration is pretty wild in this district. It's like 191,000 Democrats to about 90,000+ Republicans. And of course, a huge crowded race, as you can see on the screen right there, a ton of candidates vying for the seat. How are you gonna make the case that a Republican should be able to make it to the runoff this coming March 3rd?
Well, I believe that my political stance is a lot less progressive. It's a lot of the candidates are far left and leading into socialism. So you see Gomez endorsed by Bernie Sanders and AOC, and is that the direction that a lot of the constituents really want? I don't think so.
Well, Pamela, I so appreciate you coming here today to tell us a little about yourself, tell us about your campaign. We will definitely be seeing and hearing more from you, I feel, in the future.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Straight ahead on Politically Speaking. The eyes in the sky are having so many on the ground talking, arguing, and potentially renegotiating. We talk smart streetlights and bring you some exclusive reporting. Stay with us.